No puedo.
Okay, so we are rolling.
Should be. Alright, Dylan, get started off here.
Okie doke.
Let's see. We've got an assassin. I think this time we're going for clearing out the Maya, I guess. Cause...
Yeah.
Lich Queen, assassin. Lich Queen did pretty well because I could heal back up. Hokage did pretty well because it deals a bunch of damage. I'm actually going to go with this because the healing and the spike trap thing, it feels good to me.
Go for it. Let's try and expand out as much, especially on the right side, as possible. Because there are a couple other classes that we can unlock by doing that.
So we want to hit potion up, I guess?
Yeah.
Oh crap, we could have hit gold up. Unlock spell thief.
Yes.
Okay.
That is the first stage, and up above that...
Upgrade. And we can go ahead and do that.
Do it. Okay, we have just unlocked the best class in the game.
Okay.
Bar none.
And it's probably going to be a while before we see that much gold again. I don't know. Trying to clear stuff. And here we go. I'm gonna pick up my measly 11 gold like it's gonna matter. Practice some downward strikes. Oh, I got chicken. At least I got chicken.
So from the last time we streamed, I've probably beaten New Game Plus like 5 or 6 times.
Okay, so you just... When you're playing New Game Plus, you're basically expanding on the... existing tech tree you have.
Yeah, and I've unlocked every skill, every piece of equipment, every rune, everything. So at this point, if I play my file anymore, it's just for fun. It's just because I enjoy being incredibly overpowered.
I'm basically taking out everything in a single hit. I haven't seen any paintings yet, which seems a little odd to me. Seems a little off. It's forgiving.
A little bit, but you start out with a very small pool of mana and health.
Oh crap, I should not have done... Oh, wait a minute. No, that's not going to be a bad thing, actually.
Yeah, it kind of worked out for you.
I was just hitting buttons because I was like, I remember this does something. I don't remember what that something is.
Well, given how close you were to death, it was probably the most beneficial thing you could have done.
Now, I need to kill some things and get some chicken. I feel like this is as good as you're gonna see me do all night. There we go. And we are at the Maya now. There we go. We could technically lock this down and keep going, but
that's probably gonna be our best action. Mana cost down is really useful.
Yeah, I could see that being... Although, what is it? Spellsword gets bonuses or something?
Well, Spellsword has, you know, whatever normal spell that they come with, which mostly comes from the mage school of spells, but they also have the ability to upgrade... to cast what's essentially an empowered version of the spell. So it's the same thing, except bigger, and it costs twice as much, but it can be very, very useful.
Anyway, if we get the opportunity, I'll try and show off the spell sword a little bit.
See?
And I forgot totally to lock down the castle.
That's what? Cool. This is rough. Oh.
It's better if you have the ability to kill them, because you really can just go without taking any damage. Alright, I'm just basically going straight for the Maya.
Makes sense. Man, we're gonna have to upgrade, I guess, if we want to,
I have no idea why that happens sometimes, but it does.
What?
The spikes will just sometimes die when they bounce around a lot.
Unless they're on a timer? Maybe it's a random timer? I don't know.
Maybe, or maybe it's just after so many collisions. I don't really pretend to know.
Oh, crap!
Mimics.
Yeah, better to just bypass that whole mess.
I'm hoping to just find the boss room in time.
Okay, and then we can,
restart, yeah.
Hmm.
The sky cape is really good. I think I'm still using that.
Does it increase jump or something?
It gives you like +3 flight, so you fly for 3 seconds without having to have any, any runes or anything equipped.
Sky bracers may not be the worst thing to invest in.
Well, they don't remember what the bracers do. I don't know if they do something similar or if it's different. I just remember what the cape does.
Oh, man. Okay, that's why that room is so brutal.
Brutal.
Brutal. Never let a room walk in ways.
That's right.
That's a reference for a completely separate series for a completely separate game. I don't even know why I'm repeating that.
I don't know, because it was funny.
Okay, stereo blind, the one. So basically, things that don't affect anything. Screw it. Oh wait, spells. Fire.
Fire good.
Fire good. Alright, do we want to expand out, like, the other side, or...?
Most of the good stuff is up there at the top, which is randomized children. That's actually really good because you can press the pad once and get a new set of kids. So if you don't like the first one,
okay.
If you're looking for something particular,
we don't have enough for that.
No.
Invulnerability time up?
No, that's just like the invulnerability after you get hit. It's not super useful. Either magic damage or health up at this point, I would say.
Let's do health. Alright, let's see what these bracers look like. Guess these are... Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, those don't really do much of anything.
Just more magic.
Yeah.
Which is nice, but... Do we want to lock the castle down?
Go ahead.
I'm not sure that it matters a whole heck of a lot, but we'll see.
Well, you can teleport from the beginning straight into the Maya entrance, so...
I don't think we went this way, so let's go this way. Oh, crap!
Use your flame barrier.
Oh yeah, I guess. Dang, I hit the wrong button. Well, that was short.
Thank you for your support.
Oh, that was
good job, Dylan.
That was not a good job.
All right, there's a spell sword. It's not my favorite spell, but whatever. Well. Okay, so this is the normal version of that spell. This is the enhanced.
Okay.
So...
I'm guessing the enhanced costs more, so...
It costs twice as much. But here's the thing. The spell sword has a unique ability where they gain MP. Not kill, hit. So you can have a... effectively endless supply of MP.
Yeah. I mean, I guess it's the kind of thing you jump back and forth and kind of just rely on.
Yeah, that's why I said this spell isn't my favorite, because it's not super great for that sort of thing. But, yeah.
Yeah, but if you can cast something infinite times...
Yeah, exactly.
That was a much different experience than mine was.
Rather quickly.
Oh, I'm seeing a theme here. Let's see.
Paladin's not a bad choice.
Yeah.
They're high, they are relatively higher health heroes.
Yeah. Okay. And, you know, one thing I was thinking, I wonder if there's some value in not locking down the castle at this point, just because that's some rough... We've hit some rough rooms, and I don't know if that's... I don't know if that's representative of what usually, but I'm gonna leave these here just so in theory I can come back to them and heal up. Alright, so this would take us back to where we... Oh.
Hang on there, Dylan.
Oh man, I was not even paying attention to how much I had. Oh, that's not gonna be good. Carry chest, defeat all enemies room. Which means I'm just basically getting murdered.
You forget you have a triangle to block with.
It is true, I keep forgetting about that. Well, alright. This is not going as well.
What have we got?
Barbarian Lich.
I'll go free Barbarian Quain.
Okay.
And I'll lock down the castle on this. Because I think I can get a little bit further with her.
Yeah.
Burp, burp, burp.
He's gonna go straight up.
Might be the better option here, because... That scythe is really weird to actually target with.
Takes a little getting used to.
Knock him back at least, or something?
Not on the shield. Like, it knocks you back quite a bit.
Didn't I see damage come off of it, though?
Yeah, but it's very little.
Okay.
Like, the top of the head, or... Nope. Not going that way. Or behind the back are the optimal ways of dealing with them. In this instance, I don't have a ton of options, so we'll just do it the hard way and try not to get killed in the process.
Oh man, that reminds me of Iron Knuckles.
Right.
In Zelda 2, you had to do the jump stab or whatever, and...
These guys were always a huge pain in the ass.
Yep. That or... I want to say there's something in a Mega Man game that does the same thing. And
really want a chance getting wasted here.
And there we go.
And she's immune to spikes. Treasure, okay, cool. That's good. Ah, damn it. Got that
well,
spec.
Oh.
Bring it down.
So we got Archmage, Barbarian Queen, Endomorph, and I can either knock enemies back further or I can avoid. You know what? I'm gonna try that. No knockback. Oh yeah, we decided against the bracers. I was gonna say we see. Haven't really gone is right down
yeah.
there. So that may be the way I need to go. And this is. See, this is what confuses me. That feels. Oh, because we came up the first time.
Yeah.
Like, that feels weird. Those are fitting together. Well, this is not my day. All right. Oh man, come on. Sure, why not? I don't know. I didn't want to spend a lot of time on it. Really, you're giving me an ability to change the music when... You know what I want? I want Chick-fil-A.
Well, it's Sunday. Chick-fil-A is closed.
Well, I feel like we're missing something. What are we missing?
Yeah, we've just about filled out that whole area.
Oh, there's one in the very center. That doesn't matter. Oh, crap. Well, hey, you can start over from the beginning. I helped. I think I made it easier, because we don't have to backtrack now. I
appreciate that.
That's what we did. That's what happened there. That's...
So what have we got going on in the chat, Dylan?
Heather told me good job, I guess, because I sent us back to the beginning or so. I don't know.
Great job, Dylan. Great job.
Like I said, that first run was going to be the best thing you're going to see all night from me. And... everything else just seems to be walking into a room and screaming or something.
So where is this room that...
Okay, we go up one, over one, over two, and then up two.
Ah, I gotcha. That's it. Took a hit. There we go.
Yep. And the wolf doesn't regenerate. Yeah, so we just have to go through this long room and then up.
Okay. Jesus. Come on, Lich King.
Alright, what have we got here? We got a Hokage, we got a Spell Sword, and then we got an Assassin.
Spell Sword with Vertigo, which, no thanks.
Nope.
Hard pass.
Hokage is the way to go here, because I need extra damage. And confirm. Holy crap, I forgot how much damage this guy deals.
Oh, yeah. Got knives you can throw.
Yeah, should have done that.
Here it is.
There we go. Holy crap! And we got money that we would probably not get to spend because this is gonna be.
Of the two bosses we have left, this is the harder of the two.
Alright.
Ponce de Leon!
That is an odd name for a fantasy villain.
It is rather odd.
Well, okay then.
Let's see. Barbarian Queen. Yeah, I'm waiting on the big money spell sword that has the flame barrier spell.
Yeah.
That is seriously just forget about it. I posted a video on Twitter of one of my in-game runs with that.
Yeah, it almost seems like a strategy would be go into the castle, just die immediately, reroll.
One thing I noticed, and I don't think we'll see it here since it's raining, but if you stand outside long enough, you'll see Santa Claus go by.
Okay.
Like, he's in a sleigh with reindeer, and he's going across the moon. It's pretty great. This is one of the things I really do like about this game. There's a lot of just... neat little things like that.
I feel like it should be a, seasonal thing.
Well, it's one of those things, you don't really stand out there for very long. You do your business, you're not really...
Yeah. Yeah, I see how, I mean, it's kind of like the last one, except you can't kill off the, little purple things.
Also made a mistake, I should have save my MP for the Farota shout there.
Yeah, because...
because you can get rid of the fire.
Yeah, let's fill the screen.
That's fair.
Well, spoiler alert, this is not going to go any better. Spellsword, Scythe, Assassin.
Spellsword with the Scythe isn't the worst, because you can fire big size with triangle from afar, and where you just need MP, you can run in and hit it a couple times, and basically just hit and run.
Yeah. The other option, Barbarian isn't a bad idea, especially with Savant, because that switches up spells, so... eh, screw it, I'll take Barbarian. This is a questionable strategy, but... maybe you can get some terrain or something for Ancestors Mist.
Do not seek the treasure!
Seems like the strategy here is just to kite.
Yeah, pretty much. He doesn't have a ton of health.
Yeah, kite and then hit him when he stops. Holy crap, that's...
believe it.
Actually not be the worst combo, just because if you're having to kite him,
yeah,
fewer hits you have to make, the less chance you have of screwing up.
Plus you can teleport around, so...
yep. Seems like the trick is getting him started.
Yeah.
Cause it seems like the times I've tried it, it's, you know, if I can't get the right angle, it's just me running from him, which does nothing. Let's see. Paladin might be good. Barbarian Queen. Walking Tank. Yeah, let's go with that. One of these times we're going to forget that.
Yeah. It'll probably be me.
Yeah, it might be me. It doesn't matter who it is. It's just going to happen. And we're going to reset it. And the Maya's going to end up being easier. And we're actually going to be... more frustrated. Alright. Let's see here. Oh. I feel like if I had the Hokage, I might have had a better chance.
See, Lich Queen's right out. I'm guessing I'm going to go with one of the two assassins. And it's going to have to be this one because I can't swap my MP and HP out with an assassin.
You're the one, and you're colorblind.
Yep. So I've got this really cool looking, you know, aesthetic to the game now, but we can't really appreciate it because it's in black and white.
That was actually much better than what's happened before, so... Let's see. Lich Queen, Archmage, Hokage.
You don't want to do the Lich Queen, because you're not going to be able to build up your health.
Oh yeah, that's right, because she can't kill... there aren't the monsters.
Right.
It's just those stupid purple spike things. This will be short. I'm going. Oh, I meant to jump down and I jumped up. Well, yeah, that was a mess. We do not have a lot of good options.
No, not terrific. Guess I'll try the Archmage and see what I got.
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty good. I can live with that.
Yeah, I guess a spell that you don't have to, like, direct is much better than what you do.
Right.
So we really come down to what actually deals the most damage. You know, like the particular stats we needed.
Gonna be short lived.
Yep. Woo! Oh, yeah.
Couldn't thread the needle there.
Yeah, that seems to be the strategy. Like, if you try to make a tight circle, then you're. Oh, man. Assassin. No knockback, which might be good. But yeah, it seems like if you're making really tight circles, the fire doesn't have time to go away, like, it may be easier to do the gymnastics. It's just you've got more obstacles.
Right.
And here we go.
I don't know why this guy's being such a dick. I mean, I like St. Augustine. Shout out to Big Kev.
Well, oh. Oh, man. Whew. I guess I should have seen that coming. So Spellsword steals on hit, which means...
Yeah, I can play a much more of a hit and run and be a little more conservative. I have to be as aggressive.
Is there a reason there's no sword?
Yes, there is.
Because I missed...
Because their sword is magic.
Okay.
Awesome, it makes that cool sound. Spell swords are amazing.
Hostilion.
Here, but everything.
Yeah. I feel like it's just a matter of making the, like, you almost have to do it perfectly. That's not gonna be good. Wait, time stop?
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, I can't see hit points, so let's take time stop.
I mean, one strategy is to just blow everything at once and freeze them and just wail on them, and then try and negotiate the rest of the fight.
That is exactly what I'm thinking. And if I hit triangle, that cycles the spell, so I don't want to do that.
Right.
Just want to
hit circle.
Yeah. Or probably what I'm going to do is just wait till I get into an advantageous position.
Yeah.
And hit circle, so...
And you're out.
Oh, so that just burns mana until I probably had a chance to turn it off, but yeah. I really didn't want to.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that the strategy there is just burn it and try and do the best you can afterwards.
Yep.
Okay, I think I might have a winner right here.
Okay. It's got the scythe.
Metal blades, motherfucker! Oh, fuck. Oh, good, I didn't. Almost dead, Dylan. Almost
but
dead.
You didn't. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Alright.
Thing.
Yeah. So you got a Hokage, a Spelunker, and a Hokage with I knocked people back and I can't see. You know what? I think I'm just gonna take this guy.
Alright.
I don't need knockback.
Well, it wouldn't do you any good anyway in this fight.
Yeah. Let's just reverse direction, and that's not gonna happen. You should have picked the other child.
But we may just have to concede and just, like, stop locking down the castle and just try and grind for a bit.
Yeah, that actually wouldn't be the worst idea.
Even if we do beat this boss, we may have to do that before. Well, the other boss I feel is, like, relatively easy compared to this one, but that's just me.
No, I mean, I think that's fair to say that this one is, it's definitely tougher than the last boss. Toss up on the first boss. Actually thought
Lady D
had a chance there.
Fate's a retard. Wait, no, I'm thinking of something else.
Everyone makes fun of D. Okay. Archmage with time stop. We know how this went last time.
What are your other spells now, curiosity?
I don't even remember. All I knew was the other two were spelunkers, and I was just like...
No, I mean the other spells on your archmage. You can cycle through them.
Oh. That. Scythe.
Time Stop's probably the best one.
Yeah, I feel like Time Stop gives us... At least gives us some guaranteed damage.
Right.
Whether that actually matters or not.
Yeah.
Oh, let's get out of here. Ah!
It just doesn't seem like a great trade-off.
Well, like I said, the other options...
Yes!
Break stuff to restore MP, empowered spell. Oh, blade barrier, flame barrier.
This is the normal blade barrier. This is the spell sword flame barrier.
Okay then.
We definitely need to grind, I think, at this point.
Okay, so I'm just not gonna lock it down this time.
Yeah.
And I've got Hoggies and Paladins.
I just don't think we're at an appropriate level.
Alright. Well, I'm gonna cancel this out. And yes, we're gonna skip locking it down.
Yeah, let's...
Okay. Just wanted to double check, because that is scary, given that... like I said, I feel like the Maya may end up being easier.
Like, really, the objective right now should just be to find the boss rooms here and in the forest. Because those are going to give you, you know, guaranteed the largest sums of money.
Nope. Probably not worth it.
No, fairy chests are always worth it because they're blueprints or, you know, power up stuff like that.
Well, I think I'm going to take a hit on that one. I don't know if there's any way.
If you fly across spikes there, basically you'd have to jump very late.
Yeah. I'm gonna do a straight up gold run, I think. It's kind of my focus. It's the jukebox, is what the question mark is. Thank you. I think it's the forest.
Yep.
Do I gamble? Not sure I want to. I have guaranteed money.
Money.
Guaranteed cash money. This is defeat all enemies, not take no damage or something like that. Well, I don't know if that's enough to actually get us anything, but
we'll see.
It's something.
Which is, by definition, better than nothing.
Yep.
Hold on a sec.
Oh yeah, because we got the Ranger Bracers. And...
Go ahead and equip that, because the amount of gold you get doesn't change.
So how does it,
It lowers the difficulty of the enemies, which will essentially make grinding a little bit easier for us.
You can kill more enemies, they just drop less gold.
No, they drop the same amount, they're just easier to kill.
Okay. Why did we have it off? Because I thought that was...
I think we had some other thing equipped.
Okay.
But I'm just going to just say, hey, let's go ahead and try that. Just the enemies that are easier, it's the type of rooms that get generated.
Yeah. I can see that.
I think certain types of room construction are scaled as well based on your level.
I think we have some gold runes that may be available.
Yeah, that wouldn't be a bad combination. It would at least expedite the process somewhat. Yeah,
if the Grace Rune would affect the boss.
Maybe a little bit.
It's probably not enough to matter.
Well, it might, but I still think overall, though, we're lacking a lot, especially in, like, health and manifolds and stuff.
Yeah.
I think we were able to kind of, you know, get away with it early on, but we're kind of in that middle portion of the game where we just have to put the nose to the grindstone, so to speak.
Yeah, I can see that.
So the very first time I played through it, that's kind of what I ended up doing, was just spending a lot of time going through the first area and just trying to get as much gold as I could.
Can't get trapped.
Yeah, I got trapped. It's all good.
Yep.
Yeah, even if I die shortly, this at least makes it somewhat worth it.
Oh yeah, definitely. That was actually doable, surprisingly.
The old 1980s Mega Man skills coming into play.
Yep. So I guess if we're looking for the forest, we're probably gonna have to go.
I think we're gonna have to go down, yeah.
Here, and then probably across. Slowly acquiring chicken. Upgrades though.
Alright.
So we got Barbarian with ADHD, Barbarian with Dwarfism, and Paladin with Primaroid, Hypergonadism, Noxil, Evacro. I'm actually gonna pick Barbarian with Dwarfism because
that's why.
In theory, there might be secret passages. So attack and mana, or attack and health pool, what do you want to put?
I would put in health and mana pool, especially the mana pool. We've got very little mana.
Okay. Let me dump one in here.
I don't think there's anything else we can upgrade out here.
No, but we might have some options here since we opened up. Well, yeah, we got that one. That was the armor plus.
Yeah, I already unlocked that one.
Do we want to equip it? Because
do we have? I think that's a weight issue. We're at 90.
Oh yeah. Let's see. New. That was the ranger, which just gave us more magic. Which runes. Runes. Yeah. Oh, I guess that was. Remembering it. Balance.
Yeah, that's a good rune to use because you get MP and HP off of kills, but.
Yeah, we don't have enough to buy it.
Which was the gold on that level?
1050.
Okay, like, that's another grace rune anyway.
Yeah, everything's out of range for us at this point, I think.
Alright, well.
No, at least you get to keep 50 of that. So,
I'm a little disappointed that when your character has the dwarfism trait, that their voice isn't, like, you know, smaller.
a higher pitch or something.
That does seem like a thing that they should have thrown in.
I mean, that's really nitpicking a really fun game, but it's a very pedantic critique, as you would say.
It's
shallow and pedantic.
Guys, you missed a chance to do this weird thing here.
You did weird stuff everywhere else.
These freaking posters and pictures and paintings, I can't think while I'm running.
I forget you've got spells too, so.
Oh yeah. I'm not gonna chase all that gold because it's scary looking. Take no damage.
You can always use triangle too, well.
Yeah, I guess I will. Did not even think about that. Oh,
swinging at every painting on the wall.
Might as well. Better than getting caught off guard.
Dylan, I'm thinking for our next game we should play something like Cuba's Trip or Yandere Simulator.
Oh man. So one of the guys at the gaming group mentioned playing it, and I was like, I don't know, that seems like something. He's like, oh, it's not that bad, there's not that much nudity, but it seems like you could control the amount, and it is there if you look for it.
It's always nice when the game provides you what you need.
I don't know that I need that nudity.
Want? Yeah, I don't know.
I'm not sure I even want that level of nudity. That was, I don't know, man. don't care how many shinies you put in front of it. This characters were a little young.
Yeah.
I mean, it seems like one of those games. It's basically like Those Who Hunt Elves, the game.
Yeah.
There's really.
Yeah, you're actually super on point. That's a great comparison. Good job.
I don't even know that I've ever seen that. But just what I know of it is like, there's no reason that you should have to strip characters except.
Except for a plot contrivance.
Personally, my vote is for. I don't know. Well, one of the things I suggested was, what was it? Valda's Stories, because it was...
That does sound really
it's fun. It's going to be more of this sort of thing. I'm not opposed to Yandere Simulator or, Akiba's Trip. I just, well, other than, like, the idea of putting them on my Steam account or something.
Aside from just being morally objected to.
Yeah, like, that's not a thing I want on my Steam account.
Like, you need incognito mode for your
yes.
Steam account. I'm sure there's some privacy setting, but...
I'm not opposed to playing them for yucks, but
that's kind of the appeal for me with these games. Is that I'm not playing them, you know, for any sort of prurient material that they may present.
No,
it's really more just for the yucks.
And I kind of imagine that's true for a lot of people.
Yeah.
Despite you know what you assume, just because you know there's the internet, man. They really wanted
furry
material.
You don't need to spend $60 to find it.
Yes, and play. Man, though, that does remind me. There's some weird games out there. I saw someone tweeted about this. I think it was I don't remember how to pronounce this Twitter. But there is a game. There's a dating sim where you date girls who represent. Because of course you do.
Yeah, of course you do.
Is that all it was?
Yeah, it was just a little shortcut for you. Little short. Oh, wow.
Alright. I feel like I have to make my way back because I'm...
Making my way downtown.
I could finish that, but I'm not going. I don't want to. That's not a thing I support. Alright. I know there's not going to be anything useful in those.
You never know.
But I gotta break them anyway. Might be chicken and a root. The infamous chicken root, which herbalists of yore would use for, I don't know.
For poultices?
Poultices.
Oh. I'm pretty proud of myself for that one.
That is a pun that but no, they would use them for, you know, low chicken pants. I don't know if I said this before, but yeah, it seems like the difficulty with like nightmares and wards is that there's a dead zone on your sword. Or maybe it takes you a second to swing, I can't tell, but there's something where just because you hit X and you're right next to it, it's not going to save you. Need chicken!
Barbarian needs chicken badly. Barbarian
chicken! Was it Morgo loves chicken or something?
Mongo. I don't know. Heard too many in jokes.
Too many in jokes. Ah! Well.
You got bones.
We're gonna upgrade though. We're going to upgrade.
That's a good run.
Yeah. I am happy with that run.
Alright, what do we got? Nah, we just missed the gold upgrade. Not enough of that.
Let's say, what did I miss in chat there?
Oh, I think Heather complimented. I'm just going to assume it was my chicken pun.
Oh, bad puns.
Bad puns equal great puns.
I feel like there's only one type of pun, and that is bad. Or great, depending on how you look at it. What was the one on the armor that we just got? I think that was Siphon. Which yeah. I think is just magic, I guess.
Yeah. Tempted to do that, although we'd lose one of our jumps.
What was the one that... there was another one we had that would replace, I think, a Grace Rune? Or... Yeah.
Yeah. Balance.
I feel like, you know, that...
I'm going to leave that alone for right now. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow my original instinct and do mana cost down.
Okay. Good puns.
Bad puns equal great puns.
Oh.
And then we can equip that.
Okay. Things and it, this room is set up where it really, really doesn't want you to.
And we can all screw off.
But we don't have a duo.
No.
man.
Eat it.
Huh. There was a secret passage, actually, to get you down.
Oh, well, whatever.
I know. I just...
Didn't matter.
This may be our undoing.
No, we're good. Bounty room.
Does that increase,
Sure does.
So we got more ways to increase gold. You gonna try to find the boss, or is it just like, if it happens, it happens?
If it happens, it happens.
Okay.
My general thought is you'll get more gold in this area.
Yeah. That is a fair assumption.
But that also died quickly, so whatever.
Alright. Oh.
Fare thee well, Sir Taco the Third. Fare thee well.
Barbarian Dextrocardia.
Yeah, it swaps your MP and HP. Not super great unless you've got an Archmage. Your spell sword's gonna far and away be your best option.
I don't know, we could actually get more gold if that's
You'll live way longer with that, I promise.
Okay.
Alright. Increase your mana pool.
If there's anything else, let's just see what those runes were. Siphon rune, which is whatever. On a gold. So we've got multiple options for extra gold runes.
Right.
Such time we wish to go that way.
Don't forget, the triangle button is your friend.
Okay. Oh yeah, because I, each hit nets me.
Yep. And the spells are pretty strong.
And I just ran out, but that's fine.
Now you're back up to full.
Holy crap.
Yeah, it does not take long. It does not take a ton of work.
Guessing there's going to be nothing up here, but we're going to see anyway. Nope, there's something up here. There's a lot of something.
The triangle, man. Spin that wheel.
Break a table.
Oh.
I lost that coin. Oh.
Yeah. only problem I have with the spell sword, only thing about them, is when they walk around and, you know, they have an invisible sword.
Yeah.
So they kind of look, you know, they look a little goose-steppy for me.
Yeah, you know, I'm seeing it.
Yeah. That's the only qualm, the only quibble I have with this, the most awesome class in the game.
Yep. I can't remember, did I find the boss room yet? No, I have not, so there's still that out there somewhere.
And if you jump over it on the return trip, it'll just attack stuff behind you, yeah, it'll keep going.
That is awesome. Okay. Maya.
Point where it kind of hangs up for a second and just destroy those dudes behind that wall.
Okay, I will probably do that as soon as I can. I almost missed a clicking. Oh, really? Oh! Ah! Got so obsessed with that, which was not gonna matter anyway, because, you know.
Right.
What's gonna happen? Gold.
Like hitting stuff on like the last frame possible. Just swinging really early and walking up to it.
You mean like
like, the attack has so many frames in which it will register as a hit.
Yeah.
And so, like, I'll try and do it, like, early and just kind of walk into it at, you know, like, the last frame or two.
I can see that. That's a, helps with, I guess, stuff that may be advancing, kind of like we were talking about with the worms.
Right.
Thank you.
getting stingy about these coins in this room.
Yep.
There we go.
Actually really useful, I guess, once you get the hang of the arc.
Well, the arc, I don't know, to me it's similar if not identical to the classic
Castlevania.
Yeah. So I'm just kinda like, oh yeah, I know how to axe. Let me axe something here.
I don't know that I played much of that Castlevania. Like, I played the one with the played Castlevania 2. It had holy water, but I don't think it had axes.
Yeah, 1 and 3 in most subsequent Castlevania had the axe.
You play a lot of 3.
3 is cool because you had the secondary characters, but you could only pick one for a particular playthrough, and they all did different things.
Yeah.
Ah, damn it, I just missed.
We still got a lot of gold there, so...
I forget what the prize is. I beat it on my main file, but...
Actually, not.
I haven't got enough to do the gold upgrade.
Oh yeah. All right, Spellcat, Spell Sword. Okay. Have trouble reading things. I'm gonna wish I didn't take this. Huh? I assumed it would screw us over.
I don't ever notice anything with dyslexia. I would focus on, like, mana pool and magic damage.
Mana up. Magic damage up. Mana up again.
Yeah, that's probably the best.
We've got so little at this point. I have a thought about what dyslexia might be. Nope, 2 mana. Thank you. Okay, I really expected it to do something. Maybe it's just one of those that does nothing.
Not entirely sure what the, unless it's one of those things that's just random.
Why?
I couldn't even tell you, but... Everybody and their mother has talked about how much they hate the time change, but I really hate the time change. It does not feel like 10 o'clock.
No. We may actually want to... Actually, I need to check my... I know I've got a meeting tomorrow, but I don't know if it's...
After I have the sub soon, but that's okay. We can have a bonus stream anyway.
Yeah, we've been doing them Thursdays. I think the way I'm approaching it is just like whenever.
Wherever we're meant to be together?
Well, whenever we have a.
I'll be there and you'll be near, and that's the deal, my dear. How did I see Shakira on recently? It's something just completely unlikely.
This again.
Knows how much you hate it.
Well, there, yes. Oh, that's dumb.
All right.
Yep.
Let's make mine here the last one, and then.
Okay.
Since you've got stuff to do tomorrow, important adulting.
Hey, it's actually 10 a.m., so it's not, like...
Hey, that's not bad. Yeah, I'll take the Barbarian Queen. Marceline, the Barbarian Queen.
If we end up doing any Steam streaming on my box, do you want to stream it on your account, or...?
I mean, we can. It doesn't hugely matter. I mean, if we just want to be consistent with it, we can, but...
I'm totally cool with that, because... I think in OBS I can even, like, switch out profiles and, like, have my... But odds are I'm not going to be streaming much by myself.
I can't believe I did that.
That was crazy. Whee!
I wasn't gonna try and style my way back down.
No! That's how you die. That's how to make this run a very short run. More blah blah blah. That's probably the reason probably better we don't have a huge audience, because there's probably someone who actually cares about the lore in this.
Well, right, but if you care that much about the story, you should play the damn game yourself.
That's not true. I don't know.
Plus, you'll more or less, even without reading the journal entries, just by playing through the game, you'll more or less piece together what the story is.
Well, what is the story out of curiosity beyond...
Alright, spoiler alert, everybody. So, you know, earmuffs for the next couple of seconds. Okay, so at the beginning of the game, you're playing as someone who kills the king. Now, you're actually one of his... son, and the reason that they killed the king was that what they found in this castle was the Fountain of Youth, and the king was living forever and, you know, going batshit crazy. So, you know, at the end of the game, you fight, you know, that first character you played as. The only character that, you know, didn't die, because he's immortal thanks to the Fountain of Youth. That's why one of the bosses is named Ponce de Leon.
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah. Like, I didn't really piece that together until I was like, oh, now it makes sense, because... I'm sure Alexander and Kydir and I forget Herodotus or something. What's
Herodotus?
Yeah, Herodotus.
I think he's a may have been the guy who I don't know, like wrote about the world or something. Maybe like where you get the stories of Atlantis or something like that.
Yeah.
So. I guess you could figure that in.
Long story short, you're killing historical figures, so...
Like Alexander the Great or something?
I have to assume that who that is in reference to. Sweet spot, baby.
Seems like with the red guys, there's less of a sweet spot. And there we go.
That like a moron.
I feel like that's most of my deaths in this game. And I just walked right into that.
Oh well.
Yep. Whew. I'm guessing that's probably where we're gonna sign off.
Yep. Well, guys, thanks for watching. We'll hopefully be back on Thursday.
Yeah, or just...
Or whenever. Just, you know, check us on Twitter. Alright, guys. Good night, everybody.
Hello.